Hello, dear stranger. My name is Leo. Leo Cornell. I'm about to tell you the story of a dead man's journey through... You know what? I bloody died. And afterwards, I found myself stuck in a horrendously blue world. I've been dying to tell you this story. Literally. So, sit back, relax, and pay very close attention to my voice as I tell you how all of this began. It all started on a warm Tuesday morning in June. I was walking toward my boss's office as the doors ahead were slowly opened by his two valets, or as my boss George personally calls them, called all of us, his human robots. What an asshole, right? Anyway, as I sat down in the chair opposite my boss, he looked me straight in the eye and quietly said, with a smile on his face, "Leo, you're fucking fired." At first, I was confused and couldn't really say anything other than, "Okay, George, thank you for this." But the moment George looked away and took a bite of his tremendously green apple, I said, "George, fucking retarded." As the smile on his face slowly faded, I happily left the room. A few hours later, I decided to move back with my beloved family in the Bahamas. So without letting anyone know, I bought the cheapest plane tickets I could find, packed my bags, and made my way over to the airport. I was going to spend the rest of my days together with my family, perhaps start my own company and just live in the present. Everything was going so well. Until I realized that the goddamn pilot was fucking drunk and high. He sang "Do or Die" while losing altitude and, well, as you can see, the plane obviously crashed and burst into flames. That pilot died instantly, but I could still feel the burning flames all around me as everything went. Then I woke up. moment, I began a brand new journey. An expedition through unexplored corridors filled with familiar beauty that I occasionally stumbled upon. Something somewhat familiar but horrendous discovered me as well. I realized then that there was more than beauty to be found hidden in the corners of this new world. Again and again I had been rescued by doors. Doors that led further down into the mysteriously blue world. The further I got, the more I started to distrust my surroundings, as they got even more and more unrealistic.